I'd say my favorite Yakima slang is probably just like a typical nay. And it's like N-A-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y, like E-E-E-E-E.
My name is Kauchani Bratt, and I play Jimmy Holiday in Rez Ball. I'm proud to be of Quechua and Kwawi Tekken descent.
Hello, I'm Devin Sampson-Craig, and I play Bryson Bedoni in Rez Ball. I come from the Yakima Nation and the Pyramid Lake Paiute Tribe.
So I'm Kusem Goodwind, and I play Natani in Rez Ball. I am from the Coeur d'Alene and Nez Perce descent.
I'm Jessica Matten, and I play Coach Heather Hobbs in Rez Ball. Today, I'll be sharing some of my favorite parts of my Red River Cree Métis culture with you.
Well, I grew up Yakima my entire life. I'd say we're some funny people. We're pretty energetic. We're very prideful, too. We're typically short as well. I'm short. I'm about 5'8 and 3/4, supposedly.
I would describe my Coeur d'Alene and Nez Perce people as beautiful and resilient. You know, we've been here for centuries, and we're still here, thriving and strong and taking up space, you know, within the mainstream media.
Favorite native food is definitely bannock. It's tradition for me every time I'm at a powwow, I need that bannock with the butter on top.
It's pretty good every time I have it as an Indian taco. It's pretty universal amongst tribes and nations.
I'd say my favorite Native American actor is probably Graham Greene. That was one of the first Indians I ever seen on a big screen. I kind of remember being like 11 years old, and there's a Blu-ray disc of Dances with Wolves, and I put it in. I was up all night watching that movie.
I'm biased, I'm gonna say Chief Dan George, because his son, the late Chief Leonard George, babysat me a lot when I was young growing up, and I love and respect the entire George family so much.
I'd say my favorite Yakima slang is probably just like a typical nay. And it's like N-A-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y-Y, like E-E-E-E-E. Say if you're like, we're just BSing around or something, and you're like, oh, my leg hurts, I got hurt. And it's like, nay, you didn't get hurt, quit being a baby.
Let's go then. It's just let's go then. It's just kind of a short, simple way to say it. I say let's go then almost every day. It's always let's go then.
The biggest one I always hear, like just growing up from friends and uncles and aunties, is probably not to be whistling at night. And that's kind of universal all over Indian country too. Don't be whistling.
And every time I hear someone whistling at night, I always tell them, just when you're around me, please don't whistle.
My favorite Coeur d'Alene tradition has to be just ceremonies at the longhouse. It's a great time to just share good energy throughout the lodge and just reconnect with each other. It's always a really welcoming space.
We had something called the sunrise ceremony at the Alamo, which is a real sacred site for our people. To be there for the first time and to be amongst my people, to pray and to be in such a real meaningful site, it meant the world.
Going into the Huiach Sweat Lodge, I've been practicing that since I was about 12 with one of my uncles from over there. It really does cleanse my soul and my spirit.
My favorite Native American musician right now is actually Tia Woods, and the song that I have on repeat right now is Dirt Roads. It's a banger.
A favorite Métis musician I have would be my direct descendant, Pierre Falcon, who was a classic musical composer.
I will say one of my favorite Native designers, big shout out to Orlando Dugay. He is a Diné artist. You know, I got to walk for him in the Santa Fe Indian Art Market fashion show.
My favorite designer right now is probably Naomi Glasses. I actually met her at the Echo premiere, and she's been killing it, and the designs are super beautiful.
I'd say my favorite Native American lands is part of the closed area in Yakima Indian Reservation. It's beautiful up there. Those are the hills, and that's where Pato's at, our sacred Matlin.
My favorite res I visited was the Diné Nation, and you can see the entire Shiprock, you know, my entire view, and it's just so beautiful out there.
I think there's quite a bit, but I would say one of them is that they believe we don't pay taxes. Oh, honey, trust me, I pay a lot of taxes.
There's a lot of people out there that, like, think we're extinct. I've gotten a lot of like, oh, like, you guys still exist, or like, you guys still live in teepees. Like, as Native American people, like, we're still here. Like, we're resilient, we're strong. The future's looking pretty red.
My favorite parts about being Native American is who I am, it's where I come from, and the humor and the music and, you know, the medicine that comes from all of it.
Kind of means everything, you know, it's who I am, it's my culture and traditions. We have such a strong and tight-knit community.
I'm sending all my love to all the people of the Métis Nation.
Big love to my Yakima people out there up in Washington, and shout out my Pyramid Lake Paiute Tribe people in Nixon, Nevada.
Shout out to the Quechua and Tapilam Kwawi Tekken Nation.
Shout out to my Coeur d'Alene and Nez Perce people.
And show your pride for your own heritage in the comments.
And watch Rez Ball, now on Netflix.